the only way that we should look at this parable. Maybe we want to take the stand and look at ourselves as the sword. Jeremiah 29 says, "For I know the plans I have for your life, says the Lord. They are plans for your good and not for disaster, to give you a future and a hope." For the word of God is too powerful, my brothers and sisters, for us not want to share by spreading the seed of the gospel. So in addition for us to listening with purpose to the word of God, we want to open our hearts so that we might grow in grace and faith when we need to share our seed of faith with others. How do we bring Jesus' message in a world in an authentic way? The gospel is not something out there. The gospel, my dear brothers and sisters, is about a person. It's about Jesus. We can't give to others what we don't have. Maybe the easiest way to share our seeds of faith is by how we live our lives. For actions speaks louder than words. Our daily thoughts focus on the teaching of the gospel? Do we give to persons who ask us? Do we love our enemy? Do we pray for those who persecute us? How, my dear brothers and sisters, do we show mercy and forgiveness to others? The gospel should be governed everything we do. Mercy is the act by which God comes to meet us, the bridge that connects God and man despite our sinfulness. When Jesus died on the cross, he died for everyone. All of our sins are on the cross with him. Mercy and forgiveness is for everyone. Jesus says, love your neighbor. In other words, do good. Mercy and forgiveness is not just our mission, it's our identity. For if we are in Christ, my dear brothers and sisters, we are a new creation. Do we speak kindly about those we love and about those we don't and should? Or are we oblivious to those around us? Don't use a word of encouragement, because we have our heads down constantly on our cell phones. Do we speak up against injustice when people of color are unjustly killed? My dear brothers and sisters, at God's table, the rich and the poor, the gay and the straight, royalty and outcast will all sit side by side. According to Pope Francis, what do we do about receiving the seeds if we know our soil or field is a place filled with stones and thorns? A field, my dear brothers and sisters, is a place for sharing seeds, for sowing seeds. What seeds are we sowing? And how are we sowing our seeds? And to whom are we sowing our seeds? When we accept the word of God, when we are the field of faith, let Christ enter his word into our life and give life to our seeds. The challenge is, my brothers and sisters, are we willing to reach out and help those who are in need by sharing our time, our talents, and our treasure? Or are our seeds of faith left in the sower's bag, where they will have no use but to rot? My dear brothers and sisters, let us says he comes that all of us may have life and have it abundantly. And when we look today at some of our young people, no wonder this gospel means nothing to them. Because rather than speaking life to our young people, we speak negativity. And when the soul comes to see, my dear brothers and sisters, he never asks if you're upstart or down tall, if you're rich or you're poor. He expects possibilities and a future. So today I pray that as we celebrate this final vows, that all my brothers and sisters will leave this church recognizing that the Lord has put a trust in us to go and make this world a better place, to stand up for justice, even if it means we're standing alone. Many times, my dear brothers and sisters, I feel like those seeds that were not worthy. But there are people in my life who are sore, who said, Michael, the Lord says, I come to give you life and to give you life more abundantly. And if God comes to give us life and give us life more abundantly, then who are we to judge others? Maybe it's time that the church recognize what it means to live the gospel in an authentic way. How are we sharing the word of God in our families? I joke all the time that people always say to me, oh Father, we want God to praise, but are you praying that your sons and your daughters answer the call to serve God? It is okay for me to become a Christian. What about your son? What about your daughter? What seed are you nourishing in your families, in your homes, in your religious community? We can't give what we don't have. And the gospel emphasizes that the Lord showers blessing on the rich and the poor, the black and the white. In my life, there are many Jesuits and people here who are sores in my life. Many of my brothers are here, and many of you who have lifted me up when moments are gone. Truly, you are a sore. We walk by faith and not by sight. Because when we walk by sight, there's so many obstacles that brings growth in that seed.